In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Today, we listen to the word of the Lord, and it's really challenges us, because Jesus says you can't love father or mother more than I. And really what he encountered was a lot of tradition of the fathers that was being used against him, and so it was becoming divisive. And he was calling people together, not to be divisive, but to be united. He was calling people to love one another. And the tradition, the fathers, if you will, were saying, no, we're going to have to do it this way or not at all. And he's like, no, you're not listening like we called you to this Sunday. We need to listen to the word of the Lord. Listen to this new command to love one another. Not to do a bunch of religious things and then not love one another. And so that we can prepare our hearts to really live out what Jesus called us to do, to love God with all our hearts and to love one another with all our hearts. Let us call to mind our sins. Let us call to mind the times we want to walk in our own way and not the way of the Lord. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, princes of Sodom. Listen to the instruction of our God, people of Gomorrah. What care I for the number of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I've had enough of whole burnt rams and fat of fatlings and the blood of calves, lambs, and goats. I find no pleasure. When you come in to visit me, who asks these things of you? Trample my courts no more. Bring no more worthless offerings. Your incense is loathsome to me. New moon and Sabbath, calling of assemblies, octaves with wickedness. These I cannot bear. Your new moons and festivals I detest. They weigh me down. I tire of the load. When you spread out your hands, I close my eyes to you. Though you pray the more, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves clean. Put away your misdeeds from before my eyes. Cease doing evil. Learn to do good. Make justice your aim. Redress the wronged. Hear the orphan's plea and defend the widow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. Take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold. to the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think you that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me. And to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Lord, be in our minds and our lips and in our hearts. Jesus said to his apostles, "Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's enemies will be those of his household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it. And whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me. And whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is righteous will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because he is a disciple, amen I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he went away from that place to teach and preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, there's more to say about these readings than could possibly be done in a daily Mass, so let me just tease out a couple of ideas and just let the Holy Spirit then work deeper in your heart. In the Old Testament reading, the prophet Isaiah is calling the nation of Judah and Israel, he's calling them Sodom and Gomorrah. And he says, "I'm done with you guys. I don't want any more lambs or bulls from your stalls. I don't want anything from you that you do with your religion because you're doing it all wrong. You have blood on your hands. You're not taking care of widows and orphans. You're not bringing justice into your towns and into your cities. What I did this for was that you could truly love one another, to treat one another as brothers and sisters, and you're greedy, you're prideful. That was the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah, believe it or not. If you read in Ezekiel, you'll say, yeah, Sodom and Gomorrah, they were full of greed. They were full of pridefulness. And they did not take care of the widow and the orphans. So that's what we're really called to be. Matthew 25, people taking care of those who need it. And also people of justice, people of righteousness. And then when we read in the gospel, it just, it's more of the same. You're following in the way of your fathers, the elders. You're not following what I'm saying. You're not listening. I have come that you might be free. I have come that you might know what the Sabbath is really for. You might know what the commandments are really for. You might truly know how, what, that we can yoke ourselves to God, or another way of putting it, we might listen to God. Finally, truly, quit doing everything else and just listen to God and listen to one another. That's how we love one another, by listening. That's a good beginning to our faith. There's so much more in here that could be brought out, and it'd be a beautiful study. But what a wonderful word, what a wonderful challenge for us. God's not interested in how religious we are. He's interested if we'll do the very things he says, to love God and to love one another. That's our faith. Always was. And what a wonderful faith we have. Now, since it's Monday, we're going to let you choose your own intention. Your intention can be from your home or from someone who really needs God's healing touch. It could be for just God making something straight in our lives. Or it could be a special offering of our own heart, our own soul to God. Loving Heavenly Father, as we offer this Mass, we offer you our own hearts, our own lives, to walk in the way of Christ. More than anything we've learned from those who have gone before us, we want to learn from you first of all and follow in your ways. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for our world, that justice would truly be worked out in our world as well. There'd be less bloodshed and more justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for our churches that we all belong to, especially Holy Redeemer, that she might truly be blessed and be raised up in the way of Christ and to walk in the way of the cross. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for those who are sick or suffering, those who have any need of any kind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for those who have died, that they might see the face of God this day. We pray to the Lord. And for those who grieve, that they might be consoled, they might be comforted, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
And for the unspoken prayers and those spoken in each of the homes that are watching, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
And we bring all these prayers to you, our loving Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord, we ask you to receive us, to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer in humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. And now pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your most beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you have made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Holy Redeemer, incarnate of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and archangels, all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks and praise, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Earl, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei,
qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present to the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now physically receive you at this moment, come spiritually into my heart. You are already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Do not let me ever be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, can we say the prayer?
Christ is my reward, and all of my devotion. Now there's nothing in this world could ever satisfy. Through every trial, my soul will see no turning back. I've been set free. Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough. no turning back. I have decided, follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in these mysteries, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.